Hi, this is Dr. Islam from Advanced Cosmetic and Plastic Surgery in Danbury, Connecticut. We're here with our frequent volunteer, Helen, who's been nice enough to let us do some more injectables on her. So today we're going to be using some Voluma and some Volbella on her face. We're going to do the Voluma along the cheek areas here to give her a little more fullness. And we're going to do the Volbella down here and also in the lip areas. So Helen's already had some stuff on her face to reduce the sensitivity of the skin, and we've cleaned the face with alcohol. So just tilt your head up a little bit, perfect. So Voluma is really good for the cheeks. And as time goes on, most of us lose some fullness in our cheeks. If you look at younger people, and if you look at children, you'll see that they have a lot of cheek fullness. That is something that we lose over time, and we're trying to restore that. The other thing that you can do is you can also give people slightly higher cheekbones and fill in that area as well, which is an added benefit of using these fillers. You can also do the nasolabial folds a little bit with this. Side. So that was a full syringe, a full 1cc. And there's not much molding or massaging that's really necessary. The product typically is a little bit noticeable the first day you inject it by the patient, not by other people, typically. And then within about 24 to 48 hours, it's integrated pretty well into the soft tissues, and then the patients don't really feel it anymore, and certainly other people wouldn't know that anything was done. And I just like to hold pressure a little bit just so there's no bruising or bleeding from the injection sites. Obviously, it's important to do the same thing on both sides, unless somebody's asymmetric to begin with, and those are things that you have to look at before you start injecting. Nobody wants an unhappy patient. Some people, this nasolabial fold is a little bit deeper on the left versus the right. And some people espouse the theory that that's because when we're driving, there's more sun exposure on our left side. Sounds like a reasonable theory. Notices Helen's lashes, they are particularly long. She's been on Latisse for a long time, and it actually works really well. And she's living proof.
Helen, bat those lashes. Perfect. Thank you.
Okay, so that's the Voluma. Next, we're going to go to the Volbella. There are a lot of different filler products out there. These are both hyaluronic acid fillers, and they just have a slightly different cross-linking and slightly different characteristics. paying attention to how much I'm putting in here so that I can make it symmetrical on both sides. So I take a glance at the syringe and I also look at what I'm doing at the same time. This is one instance where I tend to massage it a little bit. And you can see I used about half the syringe, it's about 0.5. It's a 1cc syringe. So often patients will ask me, well, does this hurt? So obviously we're placing a needle to inject these, so it can be a little bit stingy, and each patient tolerates it differently. People who've had it a number of times, they are usually able to handle it well and not react to the soreness as much. And other patients have a little harder time with it, but generally, it's pretty well tolerated, and with the topical numbing creams that are available now, they actually work pretty well so that you can even inject lips and such without too much discomfort for the patient. So this is also Vibella, this is a 0.5cc syringe of it. So, and we're going to do the lips with this. So you can use the product to either augment the lips or just augment the white roll, which is here, or both, or you can augment the filtral column, which is here, which people also lose some of the prominence of over time. And it really depends on the discussion with the individual patient. So I find lips more than other areas, patients are very specific about how they want their lips to look because, especially where we are, patients tend to be conservative and they don't want overly augmented lips like some areas of the country. Mentioned symmetry is important, so I was looking to make sure it's reasonably symmetric and you don't want to overdo anything. basically it. And these are easy because you just come in for an office visit, and then once you're done, you can pretty much go back to your normal activities. There's not any real downtime to anything. We just ask patients to put a little ice on the areas to prevent bruising and swelling, and that's just for a few minutes once they're done with the procedure. Other than that, patients walk out and they're good to go.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you.